We are waiting for people to join and for Priyanka. Can we put in a subject? Navigating. Hi Priyanka, adding you in a minute. Dating apps. Post. Now can I pin this? Okay, done.
Okay, Priyanka should be able to join any second. Hi, Harith.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Okay.
So stylish, you're looking.
I was just leaving my house and I finished like 5 minutes ago.
And you got that whole Steve Jobs flag going on.
To cover up all the sweat. To cover up all the sweat then, like.
Well done. Well done.
Yes. Yes.
How are you?
Good, good. How are you?
I'm same. There's literally no exciting way to answer that question in 2020.
I know, right? But I'm just so glad that it's over now. Almost.
Almost, yeah. Counting down the days.
Yeah, I said. What plans? New Year's Eve.
Plans?
Virtual party and all, a Zoom party.
I don't know, actually. That's not a bad idea. I know a couple, like one or two friends managed to make it to town because they have like vacations and stuff.
Okay,
so I have one lunch plan.
Oh, nice. But that's,
and I'm trying to keep it that way. I don't want to like, especially with work and stuff.
Right.
I want to have to, you know, put myself at risk and then again be in a room full of people who I will then be putting at risk. So.
Yes, that makes sense.
So I will make peace with my boredom at home.
I know, right? I know. Yeah. Yay. I mean, I've been wanting to do this for so long, but I just kept putting it off. And I was
this like, isn't okay, a dating app thing.
No, like doing this live with you.
Ah, that only.
Yes. Yeah. But I'm glad I had a conversation with you because I think for the longest time I just kept trying only Bumble. I hadn't tried any other apps and I felt like I was almost getting addicted to it, like Instagram. Like as soon as you swipe, like the yellow thing just pops in your face and you just like click on it because it's just so addictive. But yeah, I'm glad I tried other apps. But yeah, super excited to tell you about my escapades.
Please tell. Please tell. Actually, will you give me 1 second? Just give me 1 second.
Sure.
BRB in 1 second.
Cool, cool.
Enjoy my ceiling.
Let me see what messages are there. Oh, crap. I'm really not good at this, guys. Okay. Superb.
Sorry, I'm back. I just suddenly got really paranoid and was something in my teeth. Anyway, I checked it before open. Suddenly, I was like, maybe.
No, no, okay. You're fine.
About the escapade.
Yes. So it all started this way. So I hadn't gotten on any of these apps. I think I did. I had gotten on them long time back when they were like new just to see what this whole swiping thing was, but that was only for like, you know, like a few minutes and then I was like, I just deleted it, right? The other day I was helping out a client who, you know, who I'm obviously assisting in terms of finding her a partner through matrimonial apps. But I felt like she was really shy and she didn't have a lot of experience talking to boys. I was like, why don't you get on dating apps? Practice talking to boys, and when there is someone interesting for you, you know, in the marriage market, like you can talk to them. But she was just being really shy. She's like, no, this is not working out. I was like, what do you mean? What's not working out? I don't know. It's very awkward to like figure out who I should match with or like who I should swipe right on. I was like, okay, wait, give me your like OTP or whatever. Like I'll log in for you and I download Bumble and I went into her profile, just selected a few people who I thought, you know, were reasonable people that she could chat with. So I swiped for her and I was like, okay, now you need to talk to these people, right? And then I was like, Hey, like I got a little addicted to it because I was doing it for, and then I was like, wait, why don't I do it like on my own? Like, not anybody else's profile, create my own profile and try and do this, right? I just realized it was so addictive to the point where I almost got irritated when I had a match by mistake. Like, so you know how like you have to like keep swiping like this, and then sometimes you go down to see what people have written. By the time you come up, you would have ended up like swiping them. Is that right? Okay. So I ended up getting a match and I was like, oh crap. And then like it got to a point where I was like, this is really addictive. Like, I don't even want to talk to anybody. I don't even want to have a match. I just want to keep swiping all day. And I just realized it's so sick. Like, you know,
It's like online
have you
shopping.
it's more like, you know what this is like? So I don't know if you've been to Bachchangudi. There's like this DVG road where like that entire road has like full of like these street sellers who have like mound of clothes that you have to like pick from to it's like that. You're just serving. Everybody is so similar, like in a way, you know, like it's just, I don't know, maybe I'm an auntie, but like I find the whole matrimonial website so much better because at least you're there for like 5 seconds. This is like 1 second, like, or maybe not even a second.
For me,
How
it was
do you
always
guys do
very,
it?
for me, it was very similar to online shopping. This whole, at least the addictive part, right? The part of like you can't stop scrolling because it's an endless scroll, and it's like one more option, and it just like gets into this whole paradox of choice thing because like you could have swiped past your future life partner, but there's this thing in your head that's like there might be someone better after this, and so that's what's dangerous about the swiping app, that you don't know what's going to come afterwards, which is why Hinge was a little bit more reasonable in the sense that there were two chances, right? Like you could like them separately and then they could like you separately, and there were two you could match.
I
But
saw that. That was interesting. Also, I must tell you about my experience with Hinge. I only downloaded it yesterday after you told me. And I felt like it was trying to play a trick on me. So as soon as I downloaded, like the first person who came up was like some Sadashiv Nagar dude. And like, first of all, the app looks a little bit like classy compared to the other apps, like the whole black and white fields and everything. And I was like, ooh, like Sadashiv Nagar boy, like, you know, like with the whole classy feel and everything. And then it was like some HPS guy and like all of that. And then it kind of, I don't know, AI or something, and it started showing me like some Kagdaspura fellows and stuff, and I was like, okay, no.
He definitely does this thing where they show you like the most popular boys first, like definitely. Because initially you're like, wow, this app has the creme
I
de la
know.
creme, you know, for 5 minutes, and then you're like, no way, that was just the first 10 people. The other thing that I like about Hinge over the swiping is that you can't just swipe, you have to like something specific, like either one of their prompts or like a photo. So I appreciate that. But you know that like the whole setting up of Hinge is exhausting. And there are all these people on Hinge who
What do you mean
make jokes about
exhausting?
it, like
What is
it's a much
exhausting?
longer process to set up than any of the other apps, and they have a
Oh,
lot more
really?
requirements for your thing to be fully complete. And so there are people on the app who's like, what do you want to do this year? Will be like, finish this damn bio.
Okay, now that makes sense. Also, and it, say that again.
No, nothing important. Continue.
No. Also, what I thought was interesting about Hinge was it didn't make putting my picture compulsory. Like in the
Really?
other apps, it's compulsory. I put my picture on Hinge later on once I'd completed registration. I kind of didn't get the point of it. But then also on all of these apps, I look for everyone. I don't say I'm looking just for men to see everyone who's out there. And I found a lot more women on Hinge, like a lot more normal women on Hinge. I don't know why though. Is it the classy fields?
I think it's also the kind of people who are on Hinge, like from in my experience as a
right.
self-proclaimed dating app veteran,
yeah, I mean, I feel
like the Bumbles and the Tinders are just like time pass. But I know people on Hinge who have found their like future husbands and wives, full on.
Right.
Like the people who take the effort to fill out the Hinge profile and actually looking for something more legit. And like one thing that I've noticed even in my time pass swiping is that people on Hinge will unmatch you if you are unresponsive. Whereas on like Bumble or Tinder, even if you are unresponsive for a few days, they're like, whatever. Because everyone is talking to like 5, 6, 8 other people.
Oh.
But on Hinge, it seems like people are being more linear about their choices. And so if you aren't responsive as much as, if you're not responding as much as the other person is, you will just get unmatched.
Yeah.
And I was like, damn, not bad. Good on you for having standards.
Right. Yeah, that's actually interesting. So, I don't know which app. Maybe Tinder, where like somebody sends a rose or some shit like that. People can send you a rose. Like, what app is that? Tinder?
I don't know.
Oh, I got a rose.
I've never sent a rose.
I've been there for like a day.
What is this? I want a rose.
And it was 350 rupees, dude. One rose. Like, I'm very flattered. Like,
must be Tinder, dude.
Yeah. So, I mean, one of these apps. So, Tinder, like, you can send a rose for, like, 350 rupees, 349 rupees. And I was feeling very, very flattered. Like, because in college and all, like, on, like, college day or, like, some rose day, it'll be, like, 25 bucks. That itself is, like, a little too much. And now I'm, like, someone spent 350 rupees on giving me a rose. I was, like,
that's for digital rose.
Oh, Hinge. Hinge has roses. Somebody is saying that.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. It's a new update.
Okay.
I haven't been on Hinge in a little bit.
Yeah, I'm feeling very flattered. But although, yeah, I mean, I felt very bad. I felt very, very bad to reject that guy because he'd spent 350 rupees. So I don't know if he's getting it back or like because I rejected that rose. I don't know. I hope he gets it back though.
They can keep it in escrow for the next month.
Yeah, I mean, I really don't mind. But I was like, yeah, I mean,
thanks. I think for me, I know I'm because I'm like a huge skeptic in about this whole thing. If someone had given me a rose, I'd be like, bitch, block. Like, no. Don't try so hard. No one wants your 350 rupee digital rose. Just calm down. Should be able to achieve the same thing with your personality.
Yeah. I was like one of those really naive people who'll fall for a pickup line the first time it's used on them. Like, because they sent me a rose, I was like, oh, like, you know. And also,
they won't get it back.
Oh.
They have wasted a rose on you.
Oh, that's really sad.
It's okay.
I mean, I was going to accept it if it was like a nice person. I mean, I don't know. Like, But
okay, so
nevertheless,
question for you.
Yeah,
you're on there as a coach. Now, once you match with people, what are you telling them?
I don't match with anyone because I'm always like left swiping all of them.
Oh, okay. So you don't actually match or have a conversation.
Yeah, I'm like, I don't know if you've seen the stand up on Prime Video, this guy called S.A. Arvind, like Tamil comedian. Mm-hmm. He talks about how like everybody in Chennai is on a dating app to see who else is on a dating app. Like they're not really there today.
They're not there to date.
Yeah. So I was like, that who else is there? Oh my God, this guy is also there on Shaadi.com, but he's also on Tinder. Like, what are his real intentions? Like,
da-da-da-da-da.
Yeah.
That's actually a really smart way of checking, dude.
Yeah, I know. I mean, I didn't think of it. Like, I didn't think of it initially, but like when I started seeing people, you know, but I must tell you one thing, one cool thing that I discovered. Of all the apps, I saw the highest overlap between matrimonial apps and dating apps with Isle. Because I think Isle is a little bit more serious.
Isle has been designed for,
so
you can walk on the aisle. Like it's not at all the same as Bumble or Tinder, for sure.
Yeah, for sure. So, yeah, I mean, something about Isle felt a bit slower. Like, I don't know if like it's purposely designed to be slow, but like it felt a bit slower, not like Bumble where you're like constantly doing this
Yeah.
and
I've actually not
yeah.
used IM. I think I signed up for it once, like years ago, when it had just come
Right.
out. And I was like, what is this? And I was like,
Yeah.
oh, this is Shadi vibes. Delete. Cancel. Bye.
Yeah, what is the topic of discussion? We're talking about navigating dating apps.
I pinned that. Ah, it is pinned.
Yeah, I don't
Anyway.
know. Yeah, I was gonna say on all these some of these apps where they can send you a message and send you an invite or something. I think Tinder has this, like some it's called some swipe, super swipe or
Super
some.
Swipe, yes, yeah. Super
Yeah,
Swipe and Super
so
Like are on both Bumble and Tinder.
yeah, but Bumble, you don't really see a message. Like, it'll just say, oh, this person super swipe you. But like, I think
Yeah.
Tinder's, you can send a message. So I got all these shady messages today saying, hey, sugar, looking lonely. Like, tell me more about yourself.
Looking lonely? How is that a pickup line? Oh my God.
I don't want to be like judgmental, but is there something like how did Tinder become that app where men obviously are like showing their chuddy like a lot of men? Women, like pictures are always focused on boobs. I don't even know if these are real women or like what the deal is, but everything is just so like come right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think Tinder was always meant to be a light and breezy hookup app kind of thing, because they were the ones who invented the swiping, right? So they were
Yeah.
very like, let's go. Yes, no. Do I like their
Yeah.
face? Do I not like their face? Like, it was never really designed or intended to be like find your sachcha pyar. It was like get laid kind of, from what I understand. And
Tell
they've
me,
always been open to that.
has that ever worked for you? Has that ever worked? And like, how does the conversation go if it's just conscious that your mom's also joined the chat, but
Yes, hi, mommy.
like.
I've never done that. Like, I've never done the just hookup situation, because
Yeah.
I can't, like, it because it's a
Or do you know
stranger.
of anybody? Do you know of anybody who's done it?
Yeah, I know a couple of people who are, I mean, they will chat for a couple of days and then meet up to do the deed. But I don't know if
Yeah.
I could do that, like, because it's a stranger. That's like the main
Yeah,
fear for
it's
me.
scary,
Like, what
no?
if I get murdered, right? Like, no
Yeah,
thanks.
yeah.
Nothing shady. Correct, it is shady. And I also had this rule for myself that I would not
Yeah.
meet anybody in person unless I
Yeah.
had a mutual friend with them. So I would
Right.
like talk to them
Right.
for long enough to figure out if there were mutual friends. Then I would check with the
Yeah.
mutual friend, and then I would meet up with
Yeah.
them and then decide. But
Yeah.
like, for the most part, in terms of people I have met in date on dating apps in general,
Yeah.
it's
Yeah.
stopped short of like 2-3 dates at the most. Like, then we stayed
Yeah.
friends, maybe we stayed acquaintances, maybe we like worked on something, swapped projects, because I
Yeah.
would I had a tendency to like match with other freelancers who were like
Right,
jobless
right.
on
Yeah.
Tuesday afternoon, but were working in the
Yeah.
on the weekend. So then,
Yeah.
yeah, I just kind
Yeah.
of stayed in touch with them, and that was it. I have not done the whole like, actually, no, I've just had this memory. Hi, mommy. So I was in Singapore. I'm in Singapore, and my flatmate, before I left to Singapore, she's like, bitch, you better
Yeah.
come back with some stories. So
Yeah.
I was like time pass swiping, and I matched with this desi person, and
Yeah.
literally my messages to them were like, I am leaving the country tomorrow. Do you want to get a drink? And he was like, yeah, for sure. And I made sure, like, I invited him to the work thing that I was at. So I mean, it's just
Yeah.
whatever, bunch of 20 somethings anyway. So he
Yeah.
came, he like I was around people where I could like leave if I wanted to. But he
Yeah.
seemed very chill. We chatted, whatever. And
Yeah.
then the next morning I left. And he just continued, dude, with the messages like, how are you? Should I come visit you in India? This and that. And
Whoa.
so I was like, what part of I'm leaving the country tomorrow did you not understand? And he was like, no, I just felt like we really connected. And so then I was telling my flatmate all this, and she's like, your one night stand doesn't count anymore. She's like, it does not count if he is constantly trying to video call you and make plans to meet up. And then it just became this whole saga, dude. So I'm thinking, finally, I've done this whole one night situation, check it off the bucket list.
Yeah.
4 months, dude, he would like
Oh
message
no.
call, and he was like, I'm gonna come visit you because he worked for Singapore Airlines. And he was like, I can get a ticket
Oh.
really easy. I'll come see you this. And I'm like, oh, no, let's not. And then I tried telling him multiple times that this is not what you think it is. Then finally it
Yeah.
clicked in his mind. And he was like, oh, I
Yeah.
guess there must be some other guy. And I was like, there is no other guy. I'm just rejecting you as a person. And then he was like, then again, weeks later, he was like, I don't want this negativity all over my social media, so I'm unfollowing you. And I was like, okay. So my one attempt at a one night stand became this long, drawn out, 3 month long Mahabharat. What a fail, dude.
Yeah,
That was on Tinder, that too, based.
imagine if it had been so mysterious where he had never contacted you and like nothing happened and you guys like magically bumped into each other some other day and he'd like, and it's this really cool serendipitous situation where you're like, whoa, shit, it would have been so interesting, except it became a really sad story.
Yeah,
Yeah.
it could have been a cool story, man. It could have been a, that's why immediately my head went to like, no, I've never done this. Then I was like, oh, I've tried and failed.
Yes. Okay. I don't know what people are saying. The Singapore guy is Ted Mosby. Yes. Yeah.
Nate. You need to talk about goalkeeper theory. What
Yeah,
is
that's my
goalkeeper theory?
husband. That's my husband. He just wants a clickbait. He wants me to reference his like blog post.
Tinder for average looking guys is a waste of time. Not
Right.
necessarily, dude.
Yeah, I was gonna actually ask you what happens to all these really sad looking people on Tinder. And when I say sad, I don't really mean about like how they look, like their face or body or whatever, but just I don't know, like not an exciting profile.
But anyone can make an exciting profile. Like literally you just need to
But why
look
don't people do
happy.
it?
Like you have a life because people don't know how to. And that's where you come in,
Right.
Priyanka.
Right,
Basically,
yeah.
I think that okay, even in terms of swiping, like I've never swiped right on the Uber sex. I mean you do because you a small part of you hopes that they'll match with you. But also for the most part, the
Yeah.
ones that I've met up with were average looking guys. Like I mean they were cute, like
Right.
not like OMG Tiger Shroff types, but just like
Yeah.
guy next door kind of attractive.
Yeah,
And
no,
so I
I'm
think
talking about like even the worst guys,
for me it's about like
like
how the stuff that they write in their profile is
yeah.
also like part of it. Like even if they were not, like I've matched with people who are not physically my type just because their bios were
Yeah.
so funny. Like if they've
Right.
said something hilarious. There was one profile that I came across, it was completely reverse psychology. It was the whole thing was just like, this is the worst person you will ever meet. Completely boring and devoid of all personality. Will 100% send you home wishing you hadn't been done this. And I was like, that's really funny. Like that's something I would swipe right on because it takes a certain amount of like
Correct.
brains to put that together. So I feel like you don't have to be the hottest person, you could just be interesting.
And how did it turn out?
We met a couple of times. He was interesting, and then pretty soon after that he was seeing other people, and then he
Okay.
became exclusive with one of them, and he let me know, and I
Ooh,
was like, okay,
okay.
good luck with your life, bye. It was chill.
Yeah. What I'm reminded of this funny thing when you were talking about like when you swipe right on like this really cool looking guy. So what I did was when I was swiping, there were like there were a few cool people that I wanted to talk to, and then I like swiped right on them. But then after a while, I even forgot who I swiped right on. I was like, wait, I didn't get a match. Like, okay, I just got rejected by somebody, but wait, I can't even remember who rejected me. So I was like, this is sick
There's a
because
beauty in that.
would you say beauty? Because I have very, very fond memories of the pain of being rejected in the past. Like where you're like crushing on someone so much for like so many months, and then you finally sort of like go confess your love to him by saying it was a dare, but it wasn't really a dare. And then he says, oh, thank you, sister, or like some such thing.
Oh my God.
And then you listen to all these sad songs and you just mull over it for a bit. Like, yeah, back in those days, it was like listening to sad songs on Radio City, but then, yeah, that was 20 years ago. I mean, but it was
No,
sweet.
dude, I'm very okay with not remembering who rejected me. I am much happier for that, honestly. Like, I don't even, if they do match like 2 days later, whatever, jackpot bonus, fine. But for the most part, I would like to just
But how do you
put
even
it away.
remember who you swiped right on? Like, isn't, I don't know, suddenly I feel so old because I was like, man, I can't even remember who I swiped right on. Like, for me to feel bad, I didn't get a match.
The beauty is you only talk to the people who reciprocate. So I think that there's beauty in that. Like you only continue your interaction with someone who has reciprocated your feelings. I personally
What
think
about
that that's
like,
good.
what about all that like one-sided love that finally gets reciprocated after some point, and the
Oh,
longing
that
and the
real life is
build-up?
there. Real life is there for you. That has not gone away. You still have that one, mysterious hot neighbor who shows up, and walks by and you never figure out who they are, and then you just think of this idea of them and, enjoy that. But real life is all is that still happens on the side. Tinder
But
doesn't
why?
replace that completely,
Yeah, but like a lot of people don't have access to that, right? Like, I feel like technology was supposed to make all this easier. Somehow I just feel like it's making it like so robotic or mechanical, right?
So for me, the part that's mechanical is not the swiping. The swiping, I still feel like, I don't know if it's become normalized, like any kind of online interaction, like it's a transient thing. But the mechanical part afterwards is the chatting, dude. Oh my God, it's exhausting. That's when it becomes hard to keep track of what you have told who, what someone has said to you. Like if you've had one conversation about biryani with person A and you've had one conversation about London with person B, and then you start talking to person C and you're like, haha, that biryani thing you said was hilarious. And person C is like, WTF, I didn't even talk about biryani. And then you're like, shit, I should have scrolled through and seen. So for me, that part is what's mechanical is you're having the same conversation over and over again. Where is like, so what do you do? How long have you been in Bangalore? I like this profile picture. Where was that? Small talk is just like, so again, in a sense, the fact that the small talk is so uniformly boring is that if one person stands out, they really stand up. Like you can rise above the pack quite quickly if it happens.
I feel like the key, right? So all these days, obviously, I used to listen to people, and I didn't necessarily have first-hand experience with trying to do this using these existing platforms. But obviously, in the past, chatting was a big thing, Yahoo chat or like whatever that was there, right? So you know how people get your attention, right? So obviously, all of my advice is very how to say somewhat on the fence, like sitting outside and like commenting on what's happening. But I feel like I really want to go through this to be able to actually tell people which of the stuff that I said actually, may work. I remember this happened to me where I randomly contacted somebody on Facebook and a random stranger, right? Like I added him as a friend because I thought he would make a good match for one of my clients. And I said, hi, how are you? And this guy says, hi, I'm good. How are you? I was like, I'm good too. Do you know who I am? I said. So he was like, no, but I know what you're up to. I was like, what do you mean? He's like, oh, you think you're the only one who stalks? I was like, he's like, I know you do something like this, you know, with the whole matchmaking thing. I was like, shit. You know, that's yeah. And that was really impressive. And we connected so well. Obviously, it didn't work out with that girl I was trying to set him up with. But we've been really good friends since. And, you know, it's been a good 6-7 years now. And it was insane. Like, it was connection like that,
yes.
You know. So when people are listening, when people are interested and curious about you, just as curious as you are about them, I feel like, you know, that connection can happen.
Yeah. It's very easy to rise above the...
Yeah, yeah.
The noise.
Yeah. And I mean, at the end of the day, you just need like one person to connect with, right? Like if you really want to take something somewhere, you just need that one connection. So, okay, too many messages. I'm like getting distracted.
I think they're talking to each other.
Is there an auto swiper? Yeah, I would like that. Somebody told me, they're like, I'll pay you how much ever. Can you please swipe for me? I was like, no.
What? Wait, this is an interesting comment. Women are the manifestation of a judgmental ideal. You are the one who selects, just like Mother Nature. Every average-looking guy has an auto-swiper in their systems. I mean, okay, auto-swipers. I have also heard of plenty of auto-swipers who will obviously swipe right on everybody. And then the moment the girl matches, they get unmatched. So that's like equally heartbreaking. Why don't you just not swipe right?
Yeah, why do guys do that? There aren't so many girls anyway, right? Like on all these platforms. So
take 5 minutes, man. Look at their face and then decide, no.
Yeah.
Because this has happened to some people that I know, dude. Papa, they would have like, you know, been really like, wow, this person matched me. I'm so excited. He seems so cute. This, that.
Yeah.
Literally, one hi, how are you? Gone. Unmatched.
Yeah.
So then you know you're the victim of an auto swiper.
Yeah, there's this one question that I had. I asked a couple of guys, I think, on Twitter the other day. Why are some guys on all apps, including matrimonial apps? What does that actually mean? Does that mean you're okay with any outcome? Does that mean your parents are on matrimonial apps, but you're elsewhere? Like, what does that even mean? Like, someone's like, yeah, I actually want a serious long-term relationship, but I wait for the girl to tell me what she's looking for. And then I'm okay, whatever the outcome is. I was like, how can you be okay with everything?
I don't know, dude. Mean,
yeah.
I have I no like idea.
All girls are bots. No. Yeah, I mean, some no, are, but... I think. Some are, no? Like, I feel like some are.
I haven't heard of these, like, bot kind of women. I've heard of sex workers and catfishers who are lurking in the women's lists. I've heard some excellent stories of people being catfished, of you know, chatting with somebody for some time and they're like, these are my charges. And these boys are like, not what I was looking for. Wow. Thank you. Dude, one elaborate catfish story, can I tell you? It's great.
Yeah, yes, yes, yes.
The ingenuity. So this, you'll match with girl A. Okay, and you're chatting with girl A. She's very pretty. She's great fun to talk to, whatever. Suddenly, girl A will not respond for a few days after you've swapped numbers or whatever. Then girl B will come and say, hey, sorry, this phone was with my cousin, girl A, who has now gone back to Dubai or London or wherever. But I'm girl B, and I have this number, and she told me about you. And I'm new to this city. So I was wondering if we could, like, go somewhere, do something, whatever, like if someone could show me around.
Yeah.
So then this person is feeling bad. You're like, okay, sure, I guess. And then you go meet girl B, and girl B basically attempts to just continue the thing from there until you realize that girl A never existed. Like, the person who wrote the story only realized that this was a scam because it had happened to someone else. Otherwise, he would have never figured
it
out.
What's the point of it, though? What's the point, though?
Maybe this girl B doesn't think anyone's going to swipe right on her. So they create this persona of girl A and get the right swipe because it's a prettier picture or whatever. And then, suddenly girl A has disappeared to Dubai.
Oh, wow. That's really elaborate. Like, that's the kind of shit I did in the holidays in 8th standard.
Exactly.
To prank my friends and stuff.
I'm like, first of all, this is a real energy draining process. Then to put up this facade and to keep your story straight and to somehow craft two personalities. Like, I cannot.
People have a lot of time. Like,
all people are just kind of lonely and desperate and will do anything. I don't know, man. I've come across some catfish boys also. But the catfish boys are too dumb, dude. They don't take this much effort and all, okay? They'll rip one photo from the internet. Okay, one blonde hair, blue eyes, six pack. And I'm like, Uncle, please. The guy who looks like this does not live in Bangalore, first of all. Second of all, there's no way he's matching with some Aam Aadmi's in our city. Okay?
Yeah.
Because I've lived abroad. And so you can tell when someone is not Indian in the way that they speak, right? Like if they are from a native speaking country like England or the UK, they very clearly speak like that. And so I just watch their sentences for some time. And, even if they're maybe like they're Dutch or German or whatever, the kind of mistakes that they make are not the same as Indian English mistakes. So I've become unsure of homes in this category, okay? You start typing to me, I'll tell you whether you're a catfish or not.
Wait, but tell me something. Like, why would you even swipe right on them? Don't they seem fake itself or do they look genuine?
There is some dumb part of your brain that's like, what if Martin from Barcelona just is real and happens to be in Bangalore with his perfectly tanned six pack and is mysteriously in
love
with
me? Surely not right now.
I don't know.
Sure.
I don't know. There's that one part of me.
Yeah. Okay. Because I did see a lot of virangs and I was like, it just seems like, something off the internet, like a picture of the internet, right? Like, why is this super hot looking guy in Bangalore? Like, worst case, he probably works in an IT company and he probably looks shitty. Like, he can't look this way, right?
Have you ever in your entire lifetime seen someone who looks at that on our roads? Never, dude.
Yeah, no.
Not once.
No.
Never.
Yeah.
There are a few virangs. And the thing is, like, they're a real virang because someone knows them because they are one of the five virangs in the city.
Right. Yeah. No, I don't think I've seen a good-looking virang in Bangalore.
Same. Also, I think if you are that attractive, like, I have male model friends who do not get on the apps at all because they just don't have to.
Right.
Women are just like... Like, whomever they want, they just have to, look at them twice and slide into their DMs and it's done. You don't need a dating app.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, tell me more about the sliding into DMs. Like, I think I tried sliding into a lot of people's DMs. You know, obviously, just to compliment them on their work or any such thing. But people don't respond. Like, how does this whole sliding into DMs thing work? If people don't know you, they don't respond. Also, to be fair, I slide into their DMs from marriage broker aunties. So they'll be like, okay, some creep.
You're not.
But
how does it work? So I will respond. So I'll tell you both perspectives in terms of me sliding and them sliding.
Uh-huh.
So I will respond if there is a genuine work-related question, where it's quite obviously like, hey, I work for this production company, I'll check their profile. If they've done some work, if their profile looks legit, whatever, I'll respond. That's one category. The other category is if someone is genuinely complimenting something that I've said or done, then I will respond just saying thank you. And then I don't really like proceed with the conversation unless it, there is like a clear outcome. Like just tell me what you want, basically, right? Like if you're sliding into my DMs, there's a reason. If you want to compliment my work, thank you, goodbye, cool. If it's like, hey, I like your work, I'd like to work with you, let's get to that conversation quickly. Because otherwise, if it's, I'm not going to continue having that conversation. So that's in terms of people that I reply to. In terms of me sliding into DMs, I think it's only happened like once or twice where like someone has recommended so-and-so hot person. And then like you go like three pictures, then they like three pictures. Then you respond with like two laughter emojis to some story. Then they respond to like three laughter emojis to some other stories. And then you slowly then one day after like a month of this dance, you say something and then they respond and then you chat for a bit. So I've had a couple of those also.
Wow, that's elaborate. That's almost like, that's like love marriage. Like, you really... The husband has a question. What is it, Skimp?
But what's the question, sir? Just you have typed question.
Unless it's my daughter who typed it.
Not Pushpavali elaborate. Pushpavali elaborate is the illegal part. That's called stalking. So that's not.
Yeah, but I also felt so sad for that show. Like when I watched that show, I just felt really sad because I do know people who are like that in their head, but probably they don't do all of those things. But in their head, like they do go through those emotions, right? Like I feel like I felt bad. Yeah. But
you're frozen. Is it just my internet? Okay, back now.
Okay. Cool. Yeah. I was going to ask you about something else. You were talking about DMs on Instagram. How long do you have to do this dance? Like the whole liking, following, commenting thing?
Before you meet.
Right. Okay. The very, very dumb question. Is this what's called breadcrumbing? No. Breadcrumbing is when someone ghosted you and they're leaving all these trails.
Dude, I don't know what breadcrumbing is. I'm losing track of the term. Okay, I don't know what breadcrumbing is, but I have read about it and I actually have figured it out. But going back to the previous question, excuse me. I would say like a 3-week time frame of doing the dance before you have a conversation. And then if you have a conversation for another like 2-3 weeks and it's like snippets of conversation. And then you meet up. Like, it has to seem like my life is very busy. I have a lot of shit going on. Like, I maybe will deign to, you know, say ha-ha to something that you've said. Or maybe I'll send you a meme based on a conversation we had. But, like, other than that, you know, I'm really not. I'm just playing it cool. Because it's not a dating app. That is...
Right, right. And that not is so Gen Z... This attitude is so Gen Z because I was speaking to someone who was 20 years old and actually a couple of people told me this. They're like, you cannot respond to people's messages the same day. You have to respond like a day later and be like, oh, sorry, I was really busy like with something. And, you know,
no, I was like, why? I will respond the same day, but like, I will not allow the conversation to become very elaborate. Like, after a few minutes of, like, even if we're both online and we're both chit-chatting, we will both chit-chat for a little bit. And then I'll be like, I will wrap the conversation up and bounce.
Got it. Okay, another thing that popped in my mind, I wanted to ask. So, a lot of people actually, they don't buy, like, the premium sort of membership on these apps or whatever. And they leave their Instagram handles.
Yeah.
Like, what do you think of that? But I've also seen that there are people who say, you know, if you've left your Insta handle, like, I think you're a cheapskate or like, I've seen both sides of it, where like people are dissing people who are leaving Instagram handles, but there are also people leaving Insta handles. So how does that work?
I mean, there's a way to like integrate it, right? Like you can just link your Instagram. You don't have to. I'm pretty sure all the dating apps have the feature where you can link it.
Yeah. But in the bio, in the bio, people say my Insta is this. I don't use this app too much. Hit me up on Insta and things like that.
I think those people are just looking for followers, dude.
Oh.
I think that's a tactic, honestly. The other thing is, I know that there are some women, I've been told by the boys, that these women will not respond to you until you seek them out on another platform. Like, you have to prove that you're that interested. That, like, I swiped right. You didn't respond. And then I went and found you. And then I said hi. And then they respond on Instagram.
Oh, dude, this is like trying to find a psychiatrist. Because some psychiatrists, those, like, therapists have this thing where you reach out to them. They will kind of give you, like, mellow responses. Until the point where they see that you're really desperate for help, that's when they'll engage with you. This is a thing with therapists. So yeah, it kind of sounds like that.
But how badly do you need me? It is kind of like that, but I mean, I am very opposed to the idea personally. But it seems like, because I mentioned it jokingly, I think once in my Instagram story, I was like,
yeah,
I have not matched with you on this platform. Why are you DMing me? And then one of my friends responded saying, dude, there are women who will respond only if you follow them onto another platform.
Got it. Oh, yeah. Actually, that's interesting, dude. I mean, thinking about, like, somebody said, yes, you're right. They're looking for followers. Now, I've got a very nice idea. I only have 200 followers. I think I'll write on my, like... I'll write on Tinder because there are like lots of really stupid people there. I'll be like, only if you like this.
Yes, do it. Why not?
Yes.
Why
don't
not?
Don't waste 350 rupees on my rose. Just follow me on.
Yes. We'll only respond if you follow me on Instagram.
Oh, done. My God. Already, I have like so many shady followers.
There's so many jilted questions and comments here. Tinder is a lie. Ghosting is the worst, but leaving a fling with a lie just fucks up your life. Macha,
Abhineet, what happened with Tinder? Yeah. What does leaving a fling with a lie mean? Like, what does that mean?
As in like a fake breakup, I think. Like breaking up over with a lie. Or disappearing
like
up
what?
My destiny. Like instead of saying I'm not interested, I don't see your future here. Being like, getting engaged to someone
died.
Else. Hi. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Two very different levels of lies. We both gave examples of.
Okay. I guess. I mean, technically, these are not problems, right? Like, I'm sure in the past, you've had breakups where people have given you some reason, but that might not be the reason. But then the frequency at which it happens is a concern, right? Like, if a lot of people are lying to you. Yeah. Can we ask for gifts if my Tinder date want to stay with him overnight? Huh?
I mean, you can do whatever you want, dude.
Yeah. I mean, if you want him to be your Rakhi brother after that.
Yeah, then it becomes very transactional. Like you're doing it for the
Yeah. No, but that was a scam that was there in school. I mean, like, obviously, I think you went to an all-girls school, so that probably wasn't there. But at least in, like, my school, it's like they would, like, girls would date, like, till Valentine's Day. Or like girls would first become like Rakhi sisters or something. And then they'd break up right after.
Because they wanted the gift.
I have this really hilarious story from one of my friends. like back in school, like I think we were in eighth or ninth. So there was so they were dating till Valentine's Day, and after Valentine's Day, like they broke up, and the guy sold his gift and made some money off it.
That is entrepreneurship, dude. That is the startup spirit on which Bangla was born. Beautiful. That's smart, dude, honestly.
Yeah, I mean, but that was the thing. Like, the whole dating for gift was a thing. Do you know people who have had success with Tinder? Yeah, I mean, for sure.
Yeah.
But I really don't know how you can have so much patience. Like, I have heard people who say that, you know, they met their partners on Tinder, but just looking at that experience from the outside right now, like when I sit and do it, I just feel so exhausted. I remember I swiped right on somebody who I thought went to the same university as me just to chat them up to see, you know, why they're there, etc. But after like two messages, I couldn't be bothered responding to them. It was so boring. Like, I was like, I'd rather swipe. Like, this was more fun.
Like, I'm telling you, man, chatting is the most tiring part.
Yeah. I mean, it is so exhausting. But I find it so surprising that no one's really tried to reinvent the experience completely, right? Like, but also I think it's a challenge to do that in a safe manner.
But the thing is, like, these are just ways to enable you to meet people. And yes, they've sped up the enablement of meeting people, but then those conversations you still have to have, dude. Regardless of who you meet and how you meet them, you still have to have that first date conversation. This is just like you're having more first date conversations than otherwise, I guess. Like, this is one thing that I was talking to one of my friends about. She got on the apps after a while, like for the first time to do it just casually. And so she started talking to somebody and he seemed really nice. And I wanted to tell her, like, Kana, guard your heart. Don't get too excited. But also at the same time, I was like, you know, if it is everything she is expecting it to be, then who am I to rain on her parade, right? Yeah. So I was talking to her through the whole thing. She met up with him, had a great first two, three dates. And then after the third date, he started getting a little, like, unresponsive, a little, like, not so enthusiastic. Clearly making plans for the weekend that he would tell her about but not invite her to. And she was in it from a perspective of like, I'm going to talk to one person at a time.
Yeah.
So for her, she was talking to one person and this one person was not responding. And she was like, are you telling me now to start over? I'm like, dude, that's what I've been trying to tell you. People have three or four of these going on in parallel.
Yeah.
You cannot do one person because no one else is doing one person. So you're going to get left behind if you're doing one person at a time. She's like, oh, I was like, yes.
A lot of women feel very awkward about it, like multi-climbing. It is quite legit. Like, you know, until you sort of have the conversation and say you're going to be exclusive, you don't owe anything to anybody. Like some people feel really, you know, like it's morally wrong to be speaking to more people at once, but it's such a huge waste of time. But, you know, if I have to kind of sum up my own experience and like what I gathered from it, I feel young people must go on these apps and explore responsibly because they still have the opportunity to meet people socially. And I don't just mean young people as in like by age. If you have the opportunity to socialize with people in real life, then, you know, absolutely explore these apps and try this out. Don't wait till you have no way to meet real people and this is the only way, because this process can be so soul sucking in some way.
This shouldn't be the basket into which you put all your eggs.
Yeah. Because I mean, if you're younger, like you're still in college or something like that, you're meeting so many people in your real life every day. So try and do more of this then, and don't be like, okay, till my career is sorted, I don't want to look at like anybody or like don't want to date. And I meet so many people that way, like, you know, well into their 30s where they've never been in a relationship. And it scares me. Like, you know, I feel like, oh my God, you have to like start here on these dating apps. It's like, it is hard. It's really hard. But you know, I'm going to keep at it.
Huh?
Say that again.
No, I was gonna say that, like, I don't know if when you're casually dating and you're younger, yes, I agree with you. But I don't know if this is the best way to like meet a sacha pyar kind of person. Because at least for me personally, that paradox of choice is always stuck in my head. Like, even if I have a great 4 or 5 dates with somebody, I'm still like, what if there's better? Whereas if I were to not use the apps, and then I meet someone organically and we have a great like 5 or 6 dates. I'm like, okay, cool. I just want to focus on this because it's not as easy to like move on. And you know that this other person may not be on the apps either. So I don't know. For me, at the end of the day, like if I'm looking to meet people, have fun, socialize, yes, but like not for the real deal, dude. I don't know. That was my takeaway. I have now deleted all the
I
apps.
think it's gonna be a while before I do that because I feel like I do wanna experience this a bit more, like go through the process. But you know what being on these apps reminds me of? It reminds me of people who would use guidebooks in school to like prep for exams like a day before, or you know, you'd have these guides, right? Like where because that's the easiest way to prep. You're short on time, but you really need to get through the portions. It's like that. People are trying to find a way to do this efficiently without really working hard for it, without building connections, without putting yourself out there, without going out there. It's
You
almost
can't.
like that. You can't get the full experience. You are not doing it to enjoy the process. You're not doing it to learn. You're just trying to crack the exam.
But
You know what I
then
mean?
the, like in this scenario, the exam is what? Like meeting someone for the first time. You can crack that also. Like I know a lot of people whom I've met through these
No,
dating
but
apps.
I mean finding the one.
So I feel like in this context, that first date, there are people who are excellent at first dates. So they're great at talking to you, they're great at getting you out first date. First date is amazing. And so that part of the exam process, they have got it down, right? But then that's where your shortcut ends. Because after that, you have to be actually an interesting person. And so I know a lot of people who've got this, like, you can almost see it, right? They've got this prepared list of questions or this prepared list of anecdotes that always works. And so that first date is effortless. And then right after that, second date onwards, it's like, zoop, you're like, what the hell just happened? Like, you were so interesting on the first date. How can the second date be so bad? And that's when you realize that, like, this person has just gotten really good at getting someone from high or a match to the first date. And after that, it's nothing. There's nothing underneath.
Wow, that's interesting because I'm reminded of somebody who told me, someone who was polyamorous, and she said, I'm really good at falling in love and I really enjoy it. But once I'm in the relationship, I'm craving the whole falling in love feeling again. And you just haven't experienced relationships and you're just not good at it. And like it doesn't excite, it's kind of like that. Ooh, we're out
I
of time now.
don't have a yeah, almost. I was checking.
And they this was
Sorry,
fun,
we
dude, but I
didn't
feel
get
like No, but
How was my
this was mostly me like trying to get gyan from you on how to do this because I like suddenly feel like shit, I'm too old for this.
It's not about too old, it's just too new. Like the whole thing is just very new. There's no one who's an expert at this except for me, who's been on all the apps on and off since the beginning of time. But yeah, it's not about age, it's just like the whole process is so unnatural. It's not a native experience for anybody. Like even if you're 20 years old and you get on the apps, you're like, what even am I supposed to do? Because it's so artificial. It's an alien experience for anybody, whether you're 18 or you're 38, dude. It's not you, it's the system. It's too artificial, it's too contrived.
Yeah, absolutely. I feel like I'd still rather have the pain of rejection, pain of one-sided love, and like all of those things. This just feels too, I don't know.
It's very fair.
I feel old in that way.
It's Black Mirror-esque. So
For sure. Cool. Awesome. This is
This
a
was
great, great conversation, dude. Like, I feel like there is going to be a part two once I've been on these apps so much longer. This is still day one.
100%. I was just going to say we should spend some more time on it
Yes.
and then we talk about like
Yeah.
my learnings as a trial and error person versus
Yeah.
your scientific view into the way the
Academic
system
view on
works.
this.
Yes. No, I feel like also someone who's an expert, like who comes from an expert's point of view, right? Like in terms of
Yeah.
relationship,
No, now I
then we
feel
can see.
I have too much imposter syndrome now. Like, I'm like, I don't know this
Did I
stuff.
even
Like, what was
remind
I
you?
talking about? Like,
No. Do it for some more time, and then we'll have another part two
yeah.
where we talk about like
Cool,
how
cool.
to do it successfully.
Yes. Cool. Sounds good.
Because I don't think I've succeeded. I just know all the ways in which you can't do it.
That's still good enough.
Something's better than nothing.
Yes,
To
this
all the
should be
comments,
available
yes,
on YouTube.
this will be on YouTube, yeah.
Yes, awesome, awesome. All right, dude. I
Okay.
don't want to be randomly cut off. I want to say bye. This was fun.
I know.
We shall do this again soon.
Yes. Thank you. This was a good idea. And as always, the
Yes.
1 hour flown by too quickly.
Yes. True. Cool. Awesome.
Cheers to
Bye
that.
bye. Good night. I don't even
Thank
know how to
you.
end this.
Yeah.
Yes. Bye.
Okay.
I said I don't even know
What?
how to end this. I don't even know
I
how to
will
end
agree.
this. It. Yes. Okay. Super. All right. Bye
Okay. Bye.
bye.